In this video, we're going to finish out the centroid worksheet on the CUDA software website, also known as coordinate geometry and the centroid. In the previous video, we went over the centroid formula, which the centroid equals the x-coordinate is the sum of the x values of each of the vertices divided by 3, and the y-coordinate for the centroid is the sum of the y values of each of the vertices divided by 3. And that is the centroid. So in number 9, we'll say coordinate C is x1, y1, coordinate B is x2, y2, and coordinate A is x3, y3. So x1, negative 7, plus x2, negative 8, plus x3, 0, divided by 3, comma, y1, negative 6, plus y2, 0, plus y3, 0, divided by 3. Negative 7 plus negative 8 plus 0 is negative 15 over 3. Negative 6 plus 0 plus 0 is negative 6 over 3. So negative 15 divided by 3 is negative 5, and negative 6 divided by 3 is negative 2. So the centroid in number 9 occurs at negative 5, negative 2. Quickly, I want to say that it's not necessary to have each of these coordinates labeled because, remember, the order in which we add doesn't matter. So since the x-coordinates are getting summed together, the order in which we write those doesn't matter. Same with the y-coordinates. As long as the x-coordinates are added for the x-coordinate of the centroid and then divided by 3, and then the y-coordinates are summed and divided by 3. So just be careful not to mix up your x and y's. Now to number 10. Our x values, 0, negative 10, and 1. 0 plus negative 10 plus 1 divided by 3, and then negative 6, negative 6, and 0. Negative 6 plus negative 6 plus 0 divided by 3. Negative 10 plus 1 is negative 9. That's divided by 3. Negative 6 plus negative 6 is negative 12, and that is also divided by 3. Each of those can be simplified. Negative 9 divided by 3 is negative 3. Negative 12 divided by 3 is negative 4. So our centroid occurs at negative 3, negative 4. And number 11, adding our x values, 0 plus 1 plus negative 2. Dividing that by 3 is our x coordinate for our centroid. And then adding 0, 3, and 0, the y values of our vertices, dividing that by 3 will give us the y-coordinate of our centroid. 1 plus negative 2 is negative 1. Dividing by 3, 0 plus 3 plus 3 is 3. And dividing that by 3. We cannot simplify the x-coordinate, so it's negative 1/3. However, we can simplify the y-coordinate. 3 divided by 3 is a positive 1. So negative 1/3, 1 is our solution in number 11. For number 12, 3 plus negative 5 plus 0 will give us the sum of our x values for our vertices. 4 plus 0 plus 0 will give us the sum of the y values of our vertices. And each of those gets divided by 3. So 3 plus negative 5 is negative 2. So negative 2 over 3, or negative 2/3. And then 4 plus 0 plus 0 is 4 over 3, so 4/3. And neither of those fractions can be simplified, so our solution in number 12 is negative 2/3, 4/3. And that's the coordinate of our centroid. In number 13, we're adding 6, negative 5, and 6. So that would be positive 1 plus 6, which is 7, and we're dividing that by 3, and then summing our y-coordinates, negative 3 plus negative 3 plus negative 1 will give us negative 7 divided by 3. Neither the x-coordinate or the y-coordinate can be simplified, so 7/3, negative 7/3 is the coordinate of our centroid in number 13. And as opposed to writing it out, I just use mental math, but feel free to write out 6 plus negative 5 plus 6 over 3, and then negative 3 plus negative 3 plus negative 1 over 3. For number 14, negative 7 plus negative 7 plus negative 3, negative 7 plus negative 7 is negative 14, plus negative 3 is negative 17. So we have negative 17 for the sum of our x value of our vertices, and that gets divided by 3. Then negative 3 plus negative 5 plus negative 3. Well, negative 3 plus negative 5 is negative 8. Minus 3 or plus negative 3 is negative 11. So negative 11 is the sum of our y values of our vertices, and dividing that by 3 will give us the y coordinate of our centroid. Neither the x coordinate or the y coordinate can be simplified. So for number 14, negative 17 thirds, negative 11 thirds is our solution. And lastly in this video, number 15, a critical thinking question. And that's because we already went over number 16 in the first video of this worksheet. So go back to the first video for this worksheet if you need help on number 16. In number 15, it says two vertices of a triangle are 0, 0, and 9, 0. So already we have x1, y1, x2, y2. The centroid is at 6, 1. So they give us what the centroid is equal to. So we have to find the third vertex of the triangle. Remembering our centroid theorem, x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3 will equal the x-coordinate of the centroid. So x1 is 0 plus x2, which is 9, plus we are not sure what x3 is, so we're going to solve for x3. When we divide that by 3, that equals the x-coordinate of our centroid, which is 6. Same method for our y-coordinates. y1 plus y2 plus y3 divided by 3 equals the y-coordinate of our centroid. So 0 plus 0 plus y3 divided by 3 will give us our y-value of 1 in our centroid. So now let's solve for x3. We're going to multiply by 3 on both sides so that the 3 in the denominator will cancel out. 0 plus 9 plus x3 is 9 plus x3, and that's equal to 6 times 3, which is 18. So when I subtract 9 from both sides, I get that x3, the x-coordinate of our vertex, is 9. And solving for y3, I'll multiply by 3 on both sides. The 3 in the denominator will cancel out. 0 plus 0 plus y3 is equal to y3, and 1 times 3 is 3. So our y-coordinate of our vertex has a value of 3. So our solution in number 15 is 9, 3. That is the coordinate of the third vertex. So with vertex 0, 0, 9, 0, and 9, 3, our centroid occurs at 6, 1. And with that, we wrap up this worksheet. Don't forget to click that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up for this video. Also, if you have any questions, leave it in the comment section below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.